Hi, this is Dr. Narda Robinson, and this is the palpation proficiency video. We have three goals for this exercise. One is to obtain diagnostic insight through palpation. Another is to be able to communicate with the patient through your hands and all your other observation techniques. And three, encourage our patients to trust us and have confidence in us with appropriate palpation. I want you to recognize that the problems with heavy-handed palpation are several. For just three, you will make your patients fear you, you will not get as good information diagnostically, and you might in fact hurt your patient. I want you to recognize the value of seeking the optimal palpation pressure. Not too little, not too much, but just right. In so doing, you will need to be responsive to your patients and only apply as much pressure as is comfortably tolerable to them. This way you will be in tune with your patient and not distracted, and you'll likely derive much more accurate and nuanced information about your clinical palpation and the problems that you're perceiving through your hands. And with the appropriate pressure, you will be able to demonstrate the kindness and compassion to the client as well as the patient, so you're not hurting them. I know in vet school, you've probably learned to use way too much pressure, on the order of maybe 5 times of the magnitude. So when we prepare for palpation, make sure your hands are appropriately ready. You need trim nails. If you look at your hand, you should not be able to see the nail come past the tops of your fingertips. You want clean hands, no greasy, smelly things, especially, of course you're going to wash between patients, right? But if you've just treated a ferret and now you're treating a rabbit, there could be problems. So clean hands, not a lot of smells, not a lot of antiseptic smells, anything, just neutral. Ideally, you should have no jewelry. Did you know that that wedding band that you wear every day can house quite a few different bacteria? Also, relax your hands. There's nothing like having your hands even clenched. Even if you're not using that much pressure, what does this look like? That doesn't look good to the client, for sure. So proper body mechanics. We don't want you to get strained or uncomfortable as you're palpating the patient. So you should be relaxed. You should be upright, in a comfortable position, whether you're on the floor or in a chair. Your head should be upright and your back supported. Next, prepare just your whole presentation to the patient. So breathe. Ground yourself and center. So the more you're present and in your body and relaxed, the more capacity they have to relax. One technique that I sometimes use is feel your feet. You might have even forgotten to feel your feet recently. Feel them, and that helps you connect to the earth, connect to the floor, just gets you out of your head. Breathe deeply into the depths of your abdomen and just feel the stress that you may have brought into the room just drop away. And now you're ready to approach your patient. So when we touch the patient, what we're going to do is start with just open hand sensing. And this will give us information about the patient's respiratory rate, the general tension they're holding in their body, are they trembling or are they relaxed, and the temperature of various areas on the body. As we're palpating, I want you to watch the patient's facial expression in terms of their eyes, their mouth, their whiskers, whatever's going on, so you get a real full impression about what their reaction is to what you're doing. We want to use the pads of the fingers, not the thumbs. When you see people pushing and pushing or holding up an animal's belly and then pushing down on their back, that's just not right. It's not good. It's not ethical. So the pads of the fingers, searching, sending feedback to your brain, palpating the anatomy, moving through the different myofascial planes. And we're going to talk about melting through the layers and connecting. You could, if you're really connected throughout your body, you might be able to feel it through your whole body, even to your feet. So melting, and that's where you're meshing with the patient. So to pass this assessment, the examining factors will be assessing your nails, your relaxation, your body support, and your breathing. The patient must not be experiencing pain. They must not be wincing, vocalizing, trying to get away. And ideally, that patient should be relaxed and you should be incorporating massage if possible. So this is a dialogue between you and your patient with communicating through your hands and through their body and make it as relaxed as possible, and that way you will get a partner in your treatments.